Good morning all, I'm Sumalata. In the previous lectures I discussed about the distribution function and density function for discrete random variables. Now we are doing an example problem based on that. We are taking the problem as the table is given. In this table X, that means the random variable having the events 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and the corresponding probabilities are given as k, 3k, 5k, 7k, 9k, 11k, and 13k. So find the value of k, distribution function, and a density function. Now this is the problem. In this problem, the required values are k, distribution function, and density function. If you are observing this table, first we are calculating the value for k. For calculating k, we are taking the probabilities. Already we know in the probability mass function, the sum of all probabilities is equal to 1. Okay, so in the probability mass function we are having the formula summation I equal to 1 to infinity p of xi equal to 1. That means the sum of all probabilities is equal to unity. Based on that, if you are taking the given table, so the events are x1, x2, x3, x4, x5, x6, x7. That means here x1 is taking as 0, x2 is taking as 1, x3 is taking as 2, x4 is taking as 3, x5 is taking as 4, x6 is taking as 5, x7 is taking as 6. That means totally in this random variable we are having 7 events, and these are the corresponding probabilities. So based on the number of events, the probability mass function becomes as summation I equal to 1 to 7 p of xi equal to 1. By expanding this summation, p of x1 plus p of x2 plus p of x3 and so on p of x7 is equal to 1. So P of x1 means, or x1 means 0. That's why P of 0 plus P of 1 plus P of 2 plus P of 3 and so on P of 6 equal to 1. Okay. So that means P of x1, P of x2 and so on P of x7. The sum of all probabilities is equal to 1. By substituting the corresponding probabilities, k plus 3k plus 5k plus 7k plus 9k plus 11k plus 13k equal to 1. By summing all these values, we are getting 49k. That is equal to 1. The required value is k. So, k equal to 1 divided by 49. So, we are getting one required value here. So, we are getting k value as 1 by 49. Now the next required value is distribution function. That means before going to do the distribution function, here k value is substituted in the given table. So here by substituting k value, the given table becomes as 0, 1, 2, 3. These are the events. Here k means 1 by 49. 3k, 3k means 3 by 49, 5k, 5 by 49, 7k, 7 by 49, 9k, 9 by 49, 11k, 11 by 49, 13k, 13 by 49. Now you are getting all the corresponding probabilities. Okay. Now the distribution function. Okay. So in the previous lectures, already we know capital Fx of x equal to p of x is less than or equal x. Now this small x is the event. Okay, the events are 0, 1, 2, 3, and so on, 6. That's why we are considering the distribution function at 0 is equal to P of x is less than or equal 0. For satisfying this condition, we are getting only one probability, that is P of 0, that is equal to 1 by 49. What is P of 0 here? 1 by 49. The distribution function at 1, that is equal to P of x is less than or equal 1. For satisfying this condition, we are getting the probabilities P of 0 plus P of 1, that is equal to 1 by 49 plus 3 by 49. Okay, 1 by 49 plus 3 by 49. We are getting 4 by 49. The distribution function at 2, that is equal to P of x is less than or equal to. For satisfying this condition, we are getting P of 0 plus P of 1 plus P of 2. So by substituting the corresponding probabilities, 1 by 49 plus 3 by 49 plus 5 by 49. Totally we are getting 9 by 49. Next, capital FX of 3. That is equal to P of x is less than or equal 3. So for satisfying this, P of 0 plus P of 1 plus P of 2 plus P of 3. By substituting the corresponding probabilities, 1 by 49 plus 3 by 49 plus 5 by 49 plus 7 by 49. Finally, we are getting 16 by 49. Next, the distribution function at 4, that is P of x is less than or equal 4. The probabilities are P of 0 plus P of 1 plus P of 2 plus P of 3 plus P of 4. That is 1 by 49. The corresponding probability is 1 by 49 plus 3 by 49 plus 5 by 49 plus 7 by 49 plus 9 by 49. We are getting 25 by 49. Capital FX of 5. That means the distribution function at 5. That is equal to P of x is less than or equal 5. That means here, for satisfying this condition, we are taking the probabilities P of 0 plus P of 1 plus P of 2 plus P of 3 plus P of 4 plus P of 5. By substituting all the values, the corresponding probabilities 1 by 49 plus 3 by 49 plus 5 by 49 plus 7 by 49 plus 9 by 49 plus 11 by 49. By summing, we are getting 36 by 49. Next, the distribution function at 6. Capital FX of 6 equal to P of x is less than or equal 6. For satisfying this condition, P of 0 plus P of 1 and so on plus P of 6. By substituting the corresponding probabilities, 1 by 49 plus 3 by 49 plus and so on 13 by 49. By summing all these, we are getting 49 by 49. That means 1. Already we know the probability distribution function final value is 1. If we observe this problem, suppose at the final value, if you are not getting 1 here, if you are not getting 1 here, then you are doing the mistake in anywhere the problem. Okay, so finally we are getting 1, then only the procedure is correct. That means the corresponding distribution functions are correct. Okay, this is the way to check whether the problem is right or wrong. Okay, finally the distribution function becomes 1. Okay, so this is the distribution function. Actually, this is belongs to discrete random variable. If you are taking the discrete random variable, the distribution function is also known as cumulative distribution function. Cumulative means we are adding the previous probabilities also. Okay, so that's why the formula for distribution function is capital FX of x equal to summation I equal to 1 to n P of xi U of x minus xi. In this, the events are x1, x2, x3 and so on x7. That means summation I equal to 1 to 7. I equal to 1 to 7, P of xi, U of x minus xi. By expanding this summation, we are getting P of x1, U of x minus x1 plus P of x2, U of x minus x2 plus and so on plus P of x7, U of x minus x7. Okay, by expanding the summation, we are getting this. In this, we know the probabilities P of x1, P of x2, P of x3, P of x4 and x1, x2, x3, x4, x5. That means in this, we know the probability of corresponding events and the events also. Okay, by substituting all the values, we are getting 1 by 49. P of x1 is 1 by 49. U of x minus x1 is 0. That's why U of x minus 0. That's why here we are taking U of x. Plus P of x2. That means 3 by 49. U of x minus x2. x2 means 1. Plus P of x3. That means 5 by 49. U of x minus x3. That is 2. And so on. P of x7, that is 13 by 49, U of x minus x7, that is 6. Okay, so by using this also, we are calculating the distribution function. How? Here, 0 is the event. At 0, the distribution function is 1 by 49. Okay, at 1, the distribution function is 1 by 49 plus 3 by 49, 4 by 49. At 2, the distribution function is 1 by 49 plus 3 by 49 plus 5 by 49. That means 9 by 49. That means here we are taking the previous probabilities also. Okay. At 3, we are getting the distribution function as 1 by 49 plus 3 by 49 plus 5 by 49 plus 7 by 49. That means 16 by 49. Okay, so and so on like this. At 6, we are getting the distribution function as 1 by 49 plus 3 by 49 plus 5 by 49 plus 7 by 49 plus 9 by 49 plus 11 by 49 plus 13 by 49. Finally, by summing all this, we are getting 49 by 49, that is equal to 1. Okay, in this way also, we are doing the distribution function for discrete random variables. Okay, if we draw the plot for this distribution function, before going to draw the plot, take the table. Okay, so x, this is the random variable, these are the events, P of x, that means the corresponding probabilities. Okay, this is a distribution function, capital F x of x, here 1 by 49. How to get 4 by 49? 1 by 49 plus 3 by 49. How to get this 9 by 49? 1 by 49 plus 3 by 49 plus 5 by 49. Okay? And so on. Finally, we are getting 1. Now, from this table, we draw the plot between x and capital F x of x. Okay? X means the random variable events are taking on x-axis. And the corresponding distribution function is taking on y-axis. Okay. At 0, the distribution function is 1 by 49. At 1, the distribution function is 4 by 49. At 2, the distribution function is 9 by 49. At 3, the distribution function is 16 by 49. Okay. At 4, the distribution function is 25 by 49. At 5, 36 by 49. Okay. At 6, 1. Okay. At 6, the distribution function becomes 1. In this way, we draw the plot for the distribution function. Next, the required value is the density function. For discrete random variable, the density function is small f(x) of x that is equal to summation I equal to 1 to n p of xi del of x minus xi. Here del means this is a impulse function. Okay, so here the events are from x1 to x7. That's why here summation I equal to 1 to 7 p of xi del of x minus xi. Here 7 will be there. Okay, so by expanding this summation, small f x of x equal to p of x1 del of x minus x1 plus p of x2 del of x minus x2 and so on, p of x7 del of x minus x7. Okay, so we know the events and the corresponding probabilities also. By substituting, we are getting 1 by 49 del of x, x minus 0. So 0 will be eliminated here. Plus 3 by 49 del of x minus 1 plus 5 by 49 del of x minus 2 plus and so on 13 by 49 del of x minus 6. So this is the required density function. Here the density function means the density function of the particular event is same as the corresponding probability. Okay, that's why at zero, here zero will be there, at zero the density function is 1 by 49, at 1 the density function is 3 by 49, at 2 the density function is 5 by 49, at 3 the density function is 7 by 49, at 4 the density function is 9 by 49, at 5 the density function is 11 by 49, at 6 the density function is 13 by 49. Okay, so the density function is same as the corresponding probability of the particular event. Okay, based on that, if we draw the table for the density function, this is the random variable, these are the random variable events, this is the corresponding probability, these are the corresponding probability values, this is the density function. So the density function is equal to the probability, corresponding probability. Okay, so we draw the plot for this. On x-axis we are taking the random variable events, on y-axis we are taking the density function. At 0 we are getting 1 by 49, at 1 3 by 49, see here, at 2 5 by 49, at 3 7 by 49, at 4 9 by 49, at 5 11 by 49, at 6 13 by 49. In this way we will draw the plot for density function. Okay, in this way we are doing easily the problems based on probability distribution function and density function. First one is, first remember the formulas. Okay, whenever we observe this problem, first identify, is this problem belongs to discrete random variable or continuous random variable. Okay, so by observing this table, easily we are saying this belongs to discrete random variable. Whenever we know this belongs to discrete random variable, then first thing is, what is the formula for distribution function and what is the formula for density function? That means first we remember this formula. This is the distribution function formula for discrete random variable. If we remember this formula, then only we are doing this problem. Okay, next one is density function. So if we remember this density function formula, then only we are calculating the density function. Okay, so in this way we are doing the problem. Thank you.